from, say, Grand Lodge and has followed through. This is something that has just gained an organic life amongst new members, yeah?
Yes, yes. It has been created by basically young Master Masons that wanted to share with all the young brethren of many lodges to share a night of fun, of casual fun.
Yes.
So, yeah, it's grassroots.
How inspirational. That's brilliant.
Thank you.
I'm genuinely listening to this and overwhelmed with excitement because I've dreamt of a time when the young people in Freemasonry have a platform to hang out with the young and progressively take it from an organic level and get out to the community. That's fantastic. So we have a future with the Blue Lounge.
Yes, we do.
Okay, so how do we find you?
First, you can find us through our Facebook page.
Which is?
www.facebook.com/BlueLoungeVic/. That's it.
Got it. Blue Lounge Vic on Facebook, and we're in. Okay.
And after, you can always contact our president, Brother Jack Aquilina, our different representatives that are present here. So obviously, my brother here, James. We have Brendan as well. And we have also Brother David, who is over there.
Right.
So they are all representatives for the Blue Lounge, so you can ask us any question.
Yeah.
We're more than happy to answer any question that you have. And we'll have soon a website that's being created. And that's
it. So for the easiest and most obvious, go to Facebook.
Yes.
Facebook, and that's Blue Lounge Victoria or just Blue Lounge?
Blue Lounge Vic.
Blue Lounge Vic. Got it, everyone? And if anything else, go like it, hear about what's going on, and every month there'll be an update on what events are taking place or any fun that's going on?
Yes, we have one event every month,
right.
Generally the third Friday or Saturday, depends on the month. Next meeting will be in July. If I can recall correctly, it will be the 30th. It will be a pub crawl.
Sorry, let me get this right, because I like your accent, eh? But did you say pub crawl?
Yes, I did.
Oh, no. How long is it taking? Let's just get this right. I remember hearing about 20, 30 years ago, 50 years ago, about brethren getting together and having a genuine party. It's coming back. It's finally coming. That's brilliant. So a pub crawl,
yes.
Right?
Yeah.
When's that one?
30th.
Sorry?
The 30th of July.
The 30th of July. Lorna? I might be busy that night. 30th of July. And other events that are taking place?
Not for the month of July, but every month we have.
And the next one will be following through from there?
Yes.
That sounds fantastic. Okay. So, I think you've conveyed the message. Is there any question that you guys, anyone has got to ask? There's this team that have created this organic, new, social, Masonic environment that's designed for the young. Yes, we have a question.
I was chatting to James before. You mentioned that partners of the brethren can come along as well to events.
Yes, but basically, these events, not only the brethren are welcome, but also the partners, because we have noticed that when the partners are able to come along and to see how good men we are, they are more supportive of the brotherhood. And if you have any friends that are interested by Freemasonry, please bring them along. We'll be happy to introduce them a bit to Freemasonry.
That sounds brilliant, yeah. Can I ask you a personal question?
Of course.
On the 30th of July, or June, or July, was it?
July.
July. And the pub crawl? Can we bring our ladies, or is it a men's thing?
No, you can.
Okay. Okay, well, you're in. Just thought I'd check. No, but, man, no white hair, I'm still getting away with it. Ladies and brethren, please put your hands together for our family. Actually, sorry. James has just said to me, he goes, would you like me to give you a perspective from an intern apprentice, someone that's really fresh into this and how he sees it? My apologies. Please, James.
Yeah, well, I thought I'd come up here and just look good. Okay. So, so Freemasonry, I complimented my journey with Freemasonry. So even though I was only initiated in February, I was contacted Freemasons over a year ago. So you've got that long period, I guess, when you're waiting, you're going to be balloted, installation comes up, so that's another week that you've got to wait. Heaps of things come up, people need to get their third degree, so you could end up waiting a long time. So during that period, Blue Lands provided me with something to do. I was able to go hang out with Freemasons, ask the questions that I had.
Yes.
So it kept me interested during even just the ballot period. And then, I suppose, it's a good informal chance, but in the South, there's toasts coming up, so you don't get the chance to get your questions answered in full detail. Like you do at Blue Lands.
Yeah. That makes absolute sense. Oh, sorry about that. We were talking about the direction and the fact that there's this periods where you're doing nothing and there's a social environment that can back you up.
I suppose, even though I say I've only been involved since February, you'd think, it's only four lodge nights I've had throughout my Freemasonry journey. But last week I visited at Diamond Valley, so I saw Blue Lounge member get initiated. Then Saturday night I had Blue Lounge. Then Sunday I had President Jack Molina podcast.
Yes.
So we spent 8 hours on that on Sunday. So that'll be starting to get released from July. There'll be a podcast. It'll be the first podcast in the Southern Hemisphere for Freemasonry. So they've got heaps in America.
Yeah.
So first for us. And then last night I had my craft lodge. Tonight I had new members night, and tomorrow I'm visiting again.
Brilliant.
So Blue Lounge keeps you involved. It keeps you interested in Freemasonry. You get to meet, obviously, it's great that you can go to a lodge and you can speak to people serve in Vietnam,
absolutely.
Doctors, lawyers, that's fantastic.
Okay.
But I suppose it does also give you a chance to meet all different Masons who are going through the same thing that you are at
correct,
the same time.
Correct.
So, it's
good. I think you've actually hit the nail on the head there. I'm so glad you actually said, no, I need to say something here as well, because that is, as much as we talked about the pub and the pub crawl thing, that's fine. But the reality is that for a lot of you guys as new members, you're in your first degree, you'll do your second degree. There are certain limitations to where you can come in and where you can't come in. But having an environment where you can catch up with a group of people, not only catch up, but visit them on their nights. Now, you know what it's like. You've done it in your first degree, and you've possibly been told that the more you get out there and visit other lodges and see another first degree will allow you to appreciate your own journey. And many a time, we're looking for that environment, and here's the perfect environment where there's quite a few fellows are in that new status that are going through that. So you've got a group of people that can catch up and catch up regularly.
Yeah, definitely. Last meeting we had, I reckon, between 30 and 40 people.
Wow.
So the more people, the better. The sooner we'll become like Freemason was in the 70s, we'll have to keep Blue Lounge on the hush.
We're in. That's cool.
But so next meeting, we're doing a pub crawl, as I said before, and as we're starting off, I think they've got somewhere in Flinders Lane,
right,
booked out. So it's a pool table we've got to ourselves for a few hours, and then we're going to start hitting CBD people. So definitely jump on the Facebook page. I'm actually an admin on the so I can get back to you on there if you do message it.
No, you're in the right direction. You're talking about the fact that we need to get on Facebook and try to find out what's happening. And I take it, when's the podcast coming in? Have we got a plan for that?
So early July, so the way Jack set it out, he's really good, he's super organised. So he's got a bank with him. Episode 1 is Freemasonry for Dummies, to answer any people's questions, which obviously I was perfect for it, because I'm a dummy still.
Right.
Just with asking questions and all that sort of stuff. The second one's Freemasonry and Spirituality, and religion, sort of how they differ and all that kind of stuff. The third one, I forget his name, but he's spent 7 years of his life talking about the trail.
Alan Richmond.
So he's a guru on the trail.
Right.
That's not a tool anymore.
No, it's all over. It's all good.
So that'll be coming out in July, so if you should check it out. That'll be getting posted on the Blue Lounge page as well.
Yeah.
There's also, if you go on the Blue Lounge page and you go down a bit, there's a 10-minute interview that me and Jack were on the radio a few weeks ago.
Yep.
So, we had a chat a bit about Blue Lounge in there, so you'll be able to get to feel a bit more of what the Blue Lounge is about.
It's, It sounds like we're going to be hearing a lot more about the Blue Lounge. A lot more about the Blue Lounge. And that's fantastic. And it's an initiative, and I think we're all appreciating that young Freemasonry is going to a whole new level. And it's initiatives like this that are coming from an organic aspect that will give it the value of the soul and the potential to involve the ladies as well and review our exposure to the community as Freemasons as well. That sounds fantastic. Okay, ladies and gentlemen.